A very good morning, children. I hope everyone is doing really well. And today we are going to do a small little revision, okay, since we have completed with our portion. So let's just start revising with whatever is coming, going to come for your essay one. Let us revise, let us begin with geography's chapter number one, resources. What is a resource, children? What did we learn? Utility or usability is what makes an object or substance a resource. Whatever you use or whatever something which is utilized or it is usable, okay, and it is beneficial for you in any way, becomes a resource, something that you use for your own benefit, for your own work, okay, that becomes a resource. Its use or utility gives it a value. For example, a pen. Okay, why is pen a resource? Because you are using it for your writing purpose. A book, why does it become a resource? Because whatever you are noting it down, it remains preserved. Okay, your food, why are you eating your food? Okay, what value does your food keep? It keeps your body healthy. Okay, whatever, anything that you use becomes your resource, because in some or the other way, it is valuable for you. It keeps a value in your life. All resources have some value. All right, everything that is utilized by you definitely keeps a value in your life. Be it a phone. Okay, now since your online classes are going on since 2 years, your phone has become very valuable for you. Okay, even before that, the phone was valuable because you have spent money on it. Okay, you have do a lot of things in your phone. Now people have become so dependent on their phones that it is like a computer in your pocket, right? So this keeps the value that a thing keeps in your life, okay, becomes a resource. Time and technology are two important factors that can change substances into resources. For example, earlier phones were utilized only to talk to people. Okay, then came mobile phones. Mobile means what? Something that can move from one place to another. Then came smartphones. Okay, so now if you can see, time has changed, and along with the time, technology has also changed. Okay, so these are the two important factors, okay, that makes a substance into a resource. Both are related to the needs of the people. Definitely time and technology today, time is definitely needed. Nothing is in control. Okay, time is not in our control, but technology is. So how technology has taken place, okay, today, and how it is getting better and better day by day. For example, if I say that I have an iPhone, so iPhone comes with various versions every year. The one who can afford iPhone 10 or iPhone X in your language, okay, the one who keeps collecting money and saves money to buy iPhone X, immediately the next month after a few months, or you say next year, iPhone 11 gets launched. Okay, now that is how, you know, it keeps creating the utility, and it keeps creating different technology, okay, in just one device. Technology keeps on getting upgraded in just one device. Okay, so that is the reason why time, along with the time, technology also is needed to the people. People themselves are the most important resource. We ourselves are the most important resource. Okay, how? Because we are also somehow valuable. Okay, more valuable than things, because we are human. Okay, it is their idea, knowledge, inventions and discoveries that lead to the creation of more resources. Now imagine if people were not there, scientists were not there. How could we have got electricity? How could we have got telephones? How could we have got different devices that we are using in our life? Okay, how could we have got fire? How could we use, how could we make things, all these natural resources or man-made resources available for us? How could we have made them, you know, valuable for us? So it is our idea, our knowledge, okay, the creativity, that imagination power, Okay, that's the reason humans as a resource are more valuable than things as a resource. All right, children, I hope you have at least understood this much. Children, how many types of natural resources have you studied? There are three types of natural resources: natural, human-made, and humans. So let us revise one by one. What are natural resources, children? Natural resources can be broadly categorized into renewable and non-renewable resources. Let us understand what are renewable resources. Renewable resources are those which get renewed or replenished quickly. Some of these are unlimited and are not affected by human activities, such as solar, wind energy. Water is a huge resource which is utilized in our day-to-day life. Okay, yet careless use of certain renewable resources like water, soil, and forest can affect the stock. Okay, even though these natural resources are available to us in abundance by nature itself, all right, by nature itself, it is available to us, but still, we humans are, you know, with the help of technology and our creativity, we are overutilizing them, we are misusing them. So, someday, misusing of them can also lead to definitely, yes, extinction of their resources. Okay. What are non-renewable resources? Those are which have a limited stock. Once the stocks are exhausted, it may take thousands of years to be renewed or replenished. For example, coal, petroleum, natural gas, minerals. All right, all those things that we extract from the earth's crust. Okay. Those things require a lot of years, thousands of years to get into existence again. But that is the reason they are called as non-renewable resources. Once if they are used, it cannot be renewed immediately. It requires years and years. Okay, even more than human lifespan. That is the reason we are told to use these non-renewable resources in limit, because they are by nature available in a limited stock. Children, now let us talk about distribution of natural resources. How natural resources are distributed on our Earth, planet Earth. Okay, it depends on the physical factors such as terrain. Terrain means type of land available everywhere. Climate, climatic conditions, some are hot, some are too cold. And altitude, the height of the land and how deep the land is and so on. Okay, and that is the reason the distribution is completely unequal. Okay, whatever is available in our country, definitely it is not required that it is available in some other country also, because the type of climate we have is different, the type of land we have is different, the type of altitude we keep is different. All right, that's the reason it is dependent on climate, type of land, and altitude. That is the reason why the distribution of natural resources are unequal all over the earth. Children, now let us talk about human-made resources. What are human-made resources? Sometimes natural substances become resources only when their original form has been changed. Iron ore was not a resource until people learned to extract iron from it. Okay, we cannot use iron ore in its original form. People used their idea and extracted iron from it. And that's the reason how iron came to existence, and we are utilizing iron in our day-to-day life. It is utilized in factories, for making different equipments. Okay, that is the reason when some natural resources cannot be used in its natural form, and it requires human mind for making it in use of we humans. Okay, and that particular thing comes out as a resource only when human has applied their idea into it, and that particular things become a human made resource. People use natural resources to make buildings, bridges, roads, machineries, and vehicles, which are known as human made resources. Definitely, see, whatever, for example, a building requires a building. First of all, it requires a land. Okay, then it requires iron rods, okay, for its rough structure. Then it requires bricks, then it requires cement, and so on. So all these things have come from the natural resource only. Then it was made into human-made resource, and finally it is finished as that product which we can use in our day-to-day life. We can use our flats. We do not imagine while living in a flat that so many natural resources have been utilized, okay, to create one flat. So that is the reason you just have to apply your mind. Technology is also a human-made resource. Okay, technology that we are using, on which humans have become so dependent, okay, that we don't run our mind, but we are dependent on technology. That is also a human-made resource. Now, children, we understood about natural resources, under which we learned about renewable and non-renewable resources. We understood about human-made resources. Now, let us understand human as a resource. We as a human are also resource. We as a teacher are resource for you. How? Because we are applying our energy. We are applying our minds, our knowledge. Okay, whatever we have learned, we are imparting our knowledge to you people. So we are becoming, we have become a resource for you guys. Okay, and you are also a resource. How? Because you are applying your mind, okay, to understand everything. You're applying your minds to revise everything. You're applying your mind to learn and then write it down in a paper, or nowadays, like we are doing online examination. So you apply your mind and you select right answers over there. Okay, not just that, whatever things you have learned in your school and college, if something you remember, you apply it in your practical life, okay, as a resource. Okay, someday you will remember that teacher must have told me this, that teacher has taught me so and so things, my science teacher has taught me this, my history teacher has taught me this, my English teacher taught me this. So you will someday in your mind, you will definitely remember and you will apply it somewhere. Okay, and that's how you become a human as a resource. Alright, people can make the best use of nature to create more resources when they have the knowledge, skill and the technology to do so. That is why human beings are a special resource. Out of all the resources, who is the best resource? Humans. Because natural resources or man-made resources are utilized by whom? We humans. How to utilize it? Who came up with the ideas of utilizing natural resources and man-made resources? We humans. So out of all, on the top of every resources, we humans are on the top. Why? Because we have skills. We have brain, we have the ability to apply our skills, we have creativity power, we have imagination power. Alright, people are human resources. Education, health, help in making people a valuable resource. Education is required, a healthy lifestyle is required. Okay, your health is also important for you to make yourself utilized as a resource. We use labor. Okay, why? Because they are a part of resource. They are doing our work. They are helping us in making our house. They are helping us in building different buildings. Okay, they are helping us in developing. They are helping us in all the infrastructural development. Okay, so we are using labor as a resource. Okay, without them, we will not be able to develop our nation. Improving the quality of people's skills so that they are able to create more resources is known as human resource. Okay, let me give you an example of weavers and iron smelters. Okay, they were so much skilled. They were human. Okay, they were humans as a resource, and they were making natural resources into man-made resources. They were using iron ore and all other natural things available for them, all other natural elements, resources available to them into man-made resources. And this particular thing Britishers learned. Okay, they learned these things and they applied it. Okay, in textile industry, you say, or in iron industry, you say, okay, iron and steel industry, everything they learned, okay, they as a human resource, they as being a best human resource, they applied their mind, okay, and slowly and steadily, what did they do? They captured the market, okay, both textile also and iron and steel industries also. Just connecting these two topics, why? So that I could make you understand how Britishers came as humans. Okay, as humans means as a resource. Children, we need to understand as human resource, as being a human and as being the best of the resource, we need to apply our mind and skills to come out with ideas on how to conserve these natural resources. Okay, see, we as humans are using a lot of natural resources. But also, we as humans need to understand that our children or our generation also need to use the same thing. Okay, so it is our duty to preserve them, to conserve them. All right, using resources carefully and giving them time to get renewed is called as resource conservation. Balancing the need to use resources and also conserve them for the future is called as sustainable development. See, whatever resources for now is available with us, that does not mean every resource has to be utilized at its optimum level. How much we require, we must utilize that. Okay, and some we can keep for our future. Not necessarily for future, we depend on more new natural resources. Okay, be it renewable or non-renewable. Okay, renewable are like available to us in abundance, so it's okay. But in non-renewable items, okay, in renewable also soil and forest and water comes under, you know, extinction when we are over-utilizing it. So it is our duty, okay, to preserve them for our future use. Okay, not just keep, you know, depending on nature only. And to have a balanced use is called as sustainable development. Not to be dependent on more resources in future, but to preserve something which we have in present for our future use. Okay, and that is what we call as sustainable development. The balance of using it. Okay, how we are using it today, how much we have to save it for our future use. And then by the time at least new non-renewable resources will get time to get prepared. There are many ways of conserving resources. Each person can contribute by reducing consumption, recycling and reusing them. Okay, everybody knows recycling, reusing, okay, reducing is a vicious cycle. Okay, you have to reduce, you have to reuse and you have to recycle. And things are now getting produced in the same way. For example, polythene. Polythene is now available in market that can be reused or recycled. Okay, and it is not harming the environment. Ultimately, it makes conservation of resources. The future of our planet and its people is linked with our ability to maintain and preserve the life support system that nature provides us. Okay, we are responsible to preserve life support system that nature is providing us. Therefore, it is our duty to ensure that first, all uses of renewable resources are sustainable. Okay, sustainable means every use has to be balanced. The diversity of life on the earth is conserved. Okay, whatever diversities we have in plants, in flora and fauna, everything has to be conserved on its place. It should not be killed unnecessarily, they should not be consumed unnecessarily. Okay, the damage of natural environmental system is minimized. We should see to it that the damage is minimized by at least humans. Okay, and whatever natural damage is happening, at least humans can try to, you know, renovate it with their own skill and with their own creative ideas. I hope you all have understood. We just have roughly revised the chapter. Okay, these are a few pictures that I wanted to show about natural resources. Okay, renewable and non-renewable resources. Okay, in renewable we have solar energy, we have biomass, we have wind energy, we have geothermal, we have hydel powers. Okay, hydel energy. And in non-renewable we have coal, we have fuel, we have nuclear, we have natural gas that is extracted from the crust, earth's crust. Okay, and here we have a picture of how natural resources are converted into man-made resources. Rubber is used for making tires, wood is used for making furniture, metals are used for making different utensils, and sand has been used to make clay pots. Here, copper is used to make different statues. Okay, in creative ideas, copper is also used as, you know, wires for electricity and so on. And human as a resource. When humans apply their mind, what happens? Okay, it is beneficial for humans. Okay, recruitment happens. You can be an employee or you can be an employer. Then skills you apply, then you come out with different talents, then you try to develop yourself first and then you try to develop others. okay, and then you set a certain goal, also you get trained, and also you can train people, those are working under you. So humans as a resource are a big thing, okay, and when human is not acting like a resource, natural resource or man-made resource will never be utilized by them. So my dear children, I hope you all have understood whatever has been revised today. Okay, in my next video, we will be doing another revision of another chapter. By that time, take care and keep studying, and all the best for your exams.